Hi, my dear students. I welcome you all today's online class. Today we are going to learn the remaining part of the story, the tale of Castor the Dragon. We already discussed page number 129 and a half part of 130 page number. Then the remaining part we can learn today. Before that, we just recall the short summary of the earlier class. The poem, The Tale of Castor the Dragon, was written by Ogden Nash. It is a story. It is a poem, but it tells a story. It is a funny and humorous poem. It tells the story of a little girl named Belinda, who keeps little pets. Some pets are black kitten, she named it Ink, and a mouse named Bling, a dog named Mustard, a dragon named Castor. These are the pets of Belinda. She lives in a little house. Her pets, except the dragon, that means the Castor, have been described a very, very brave. The dragon, however, shows and proves his bravery when he kills a pirate who enters Belinda's house. That is the short summary of the poem, The Tale of Castor the Dragon. All my dear students, page number 130, stanza 4, we finished. The story, we stopped the story here. The pirate reached Belinda's house. He looks very dangerous. That means the pirate looks very dangerous. He is carrying many arms, pistol in his both hands. Both arms there are pistol. It is very clear that the pirate means very harm to the inmates of the house. He says, or he symbolizes danger to all. That stanza for page number 130 says. Then dear students, the remaining part, stanza 5th onwards, we can learn now. Please take page number 130, dear my students. Stanza 5. Belinda paled and she cried, "Help, help!" But the mustard fled with a terrified yelp. Ink trickled down to the bottom of the household, and a little mouse Bling strategically mouse holed. Let us learn by line by line explanation. Belinda played. Pirate enters the house of Belinda. Belinda paled. Paled means got yellow or yellowish. That means got feared. She cried, "Help, help!" But mustard fled. Mustard. They all say that all are very brave. But at that critical situation, mustard fled. Fled means escaped or ran with a terrified yelp. Terrified yelp means a fearful sound. With a fearful sound, it escaped. ink trickled down. Trickle down means it went down to the bottom of the household, just escaped or ended, went to the household things. And the little mouse blink strategically, mouse hold means it got into the hole, entered into hole. That means all brave, they say all are brave, but all escaped at this critical situation. Next stanza. But up jumped a castor, snorting like an engine, clashing his tail like an iron and in a jungle, with a chatter and a clank and a jangling scrum, he went at the pirate like a robin at a worm. Up jumped a castor. Castor is considered as very coward, but that jumped, snorting like an engine. Snorting means sound from his nose. That means it made a sound. He made a sound like an engine. Clashed his tail. Clash means struck his tail like an iron in a jungle. Iron means iron. Iron and jungle. Jungle means curve. In a curve, it is like an iron. He struck it with a clatter and a clang and a jangling scrum. This word meaning is sound of iron. Iron sound. That sound he made it and just jumped into the pirate. He went at a pirate like a robin. How he jumped or went there like a robin at a worm. At the time of jumping at the worm, like a robin, it jumped. Castor jumped at the pirate. The next stanza, the pirate gaped at Belinda's dragon and gulped some grog from his pocket flagon. He fired two bullets, but they didn't hit, and Castor gobbled him a very bit. The pirate gaped means looked at Belinda's dragon, and the dragon, the pirate looked, gulped means swallowed some grog, rug means some liquor or wine, from his pocket flagon, pocket container, there are some wine, it drank it. And he fired two bullets, just fired two bullets at the castor, but they didn't hit. That bullet wasted. And castor gobbled him a very bit. At that moment, castor gobbled means swallowed a very bit. Everything he swallowed. The next stanza, Belinda embraced him, mustard licked him, no one mourned for his pirate victim. Ing and Bling in a glee did gyrate around the dragon that ate the pirate. Belinda embraced means hanged him, mustard licked means passed the tongue over, licked him. No one mourned, no one lamented for the pirate's victim. Ing and Bling in a glee, all are in a happy. Did Jorrit, that means that took around the castor, around the dragon that ate pirate. Dragon helped all. Now all escaped. Who helped? Dragon escaped. How? Dragon ate the pirate. So all are in a happy. All other members told they are brave, but when pirate enters, they escaped. Castor is considered as coward, but he helped to escape all other members. The next stanza. But presently up spoke little dog Mustard, I would have been twice as brave if I hadn't been flustered. And up spoke Ink and up spoke Blink. We had been three times as brave, we think. And Custard said, I quite agree that everybody is braver than me. Spoke Dog Mustard, spoke, I would have been twice as brave. Now they also boasting, all are very brave. If I hadn't been frustrated, frustrated means got nervous. If he hadn't been nervous, he would have been brave, he told. We have been three times as brave, we think, and Custard said. Others all told, they also might be very strong. Ink, Blink also told, they all have been three times as brave. If they think, they told like that. At that time, Custard, he is already considered as very coward. He told, yes, I quite agree. Who is I? Custard the dragon quite agree that everybody is braver than me. Everybody, all are braver than Custard. Next stanza, Belinda still lives in her little white house with her little black kitten and her little grey mouse and her little yellow dog and her little red wagon and her really true little pet dragon. It is a repetition of first stanza, but the difference is there. What is the difference? First is in past, now it is in present. Why it is present? That is a question. It is present and so why? It shows the permanence of the situation or continuity of the situation. The stanza says, Belinda still lives in her little that house. Who are there? Black kitten is there. A little grey mouse is there, little yellow dog is there, and red wagon is there. All are in. And also dragon is there. Next stanza. Belinda is as brave as a barrel of beers. And Ink and Blink chase lions down the stairs. Mustard is as brave as a tiger in a rage. But Custard keeps crying for a nice safe cage. This stanza also we already discussed it. Belinda as brave as barrel of beers. That much powerful is Belinda. Ink and Blink chase lion down the stair. Chase lion. That much brave is there. Mustard is brave. How? Like a tiger in a rage. But Custard is very coward, crying for nice cage. It says, glitters is not gold. All glitters is not gold, that the poem says. In our life also, we have this type of experience we may face. The chapter says like this, all glitters is not gold. All my dear students, I hope you all got idea about the poem, The Tale of Custard the Dragon. Let me stop here. Thank you. Have a nice day.